Hi, I'm Jason Isabelle, Cervid Program Supervisor with the Missouri Department of Conservation. I'll be speaking about the differences between two diseases found in Missouri's deer herd: hemorrhagic disease, commonly referred to as EHD or blue tongue, and chronic wasting disease, or CWD. Hemorrhagic diseases include both the blue tongue and epizootic hemorrhagic disease viruses, or EHD. Because EHD is more common in Missouri than blue tongue, I'll refer to hemorrhagic disease simply as EHD. EHD is a virus carried by a biting midge fly in late summer. In contrast, CWD is a disease caused by a misfolded protein. Midge flies can transmit EHD when the flies bite a deer, but EHD cannot be transmitted directly between deer. CWD can be spread by direct deer-to-deer contact, when deer contact an infected carcass, or when deer encounter the infectious proteins after they've been shed in the environment by an infected deer. When cold weather arrives in fall, the midges that transmit EHD die, and the cycle of disease transmission ends for the year. Unlike EHD, the transmission cycle for CWD does not stop. As long as infected deer exist on the landscape, CWD continues to spread. EHD cannot survive outside the body of a midge or deer, whereas infectious CWD proteins are shed by deer and can persist in the environment for years. Humans cannot become infected with EHD either through insect bites or through handling or consuming infected deer. There have been no known cases of CWD affecting humans, but the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention advises hunters to avoid consuming venison from deer that test positive for the disease. Although most deer in Missouri that get EHD die from the virus, some survive. Unlike EHD, CWD is 100% fatal. In states where a high percentage of the deer herd has CWD, it is a common cause of death. Deer that have EHD become lethargic, develop a high fever, have swelling in the head and neck, and have mouth ulcers and internal bleeding. These symptoms become visible shortly after deer become infected with EHD. EHD kills deer quickly, usually within a week or two. Because EHD causes high fever and the midges that transmit EHD breed along the water's edge, most deer that die from EHD are found near water. Because the disease occurs during a relatively narrow window in late summer, during a severe EHD outbreak, it is common to see numerous dead deer, often in one location. In contrast, CWD causes a deer's brain to deteriorate slowly over time. Deer with CWD look perfectly healthy for the first year and a half to 2 years after becoming infected. After that, visible symptoms appear, and deer die within a few weeks to months. Visible symptoms of CWD include significant weight loss, drooping head and ears, impaired coordination, and excessive salivation. Because very few deer have CWD in Missouri currently, and because CWD increases the chances that a deer will die from other causes, it is not common to see deer with clinical signs of CWD in Missouri. That does not mean that CWD is not a threat to the deer herd or that EHD is a more significant threat. It's quite the opposite. EHD is not a long-term threat to the health of the herd. Missouri's deer herd has experienced several hemorrhagic disease outbreaks over the last 5 decades. Even after a severe outbreak, the deer population recovers within a few years. In contrast, CWD is a significant long-term threat to the health and sustainability of Missouri's deer herd. If CWD is not managed, the deer herd will experience significant long-term population declines, and there will be fewer mature bucks and does in the population. There aren't many things that hunters can do to affect EHD in Missouri except reducing antlerless harvest after a severe outbreak. There are, however, several things that hunters can do to help slow the spread of CWD. These include harvesting additional deer in areas that have CWD, having their deer tested for the disease, following the carcass disposal regulations and the prohibition on placing feed and mineral for deer, and educating others about the importance of CWD management. MDC and deer hunters share the same goal, to have a healthy deer herd. MDC is entrusted with protecting Missouri's deer population, and to do this, we must manage CWD. CWD is still rare in Missouri's deer population thanks to successful management efforts and cooperation of hunters, landowners, and other partners. By continuing to work together, we can protect Missouri's deer population from CWD and ensure that this cherished and iconic natural resource remains healthy for the generations that follow.